Hi, and welcome to another episode of my new series of tutorials for Affinity Photo for iPad, where we go through different editing tools. In each video, I only go through one function. It'll be easier for you to find whatever you're looking for, and it also makes it easier to learn new stuff. So in the first one, I went through the inpainting brush and the clone stamp tool, where we learned how to remove small stuff from the image. And in this one, I want to show you how you can increase the size of your background in case you have a subject that's too close to the walls or too close to the top or bottom, and that might prevent you from doing a nice composition when you crop. So for this, I have found a raw image of an eagle grabbing a fish. So this image is completely raw. I haven't done anything to it, and we're not going to do any edits per se today, but I want to show you how you can use your crop tool to increase the size of the background. Because in this case, I think the image of the eagle it's nice and it's sharp, but I don't like how far to the left the eagle is in the image. And I wasn't quick enough to move with the eagle in this case and do the composition correctly the first time. So for this one, I open my image in Affinity Photo and I look at my image, I choose my crop tool, and I figure out how I would ideally want to crop it. And I think something like this would be good. I click apply, and normally we would use the crop tool to decrease the image size or do something like this. In this case, we want to do it the opposite way, so I'm actually increasing the image. I click apply when I'm satisfied with the size of the new canvas. And as you can see here, we have some blank areas, some transparent areas, because there's just no information at all in the image in these areas. To fix this, we use some of the same technology that the inpainting brush is using. And we take our selection tool. It could be either selection tool. I use the rectangular one for this, but it's completely up to you. And I select the area I want to fill out. And I go to my filters and I scroll down. These filters are in alphabetical order, and we're looking for the filter called fill. That's right here. And when you open this filter, it defaults on a color mode with the white color. That's not what we want. We want to go to inpainting. That's what Photoshop calls content aware. And then it'll calculate what will actually be filled out in this image. And I can click apply. It takes a second. I can then deselect. I can do this either by going here to deselect, or I can just choose my selection tool and click once someplace. There are a few things we should fix here, but I'll do that lastly. I want to first do a new selection and fill out this top part. I go to my filters again. I choose fill. It now defaults on inpainting because that's what we used last time. And I can click apply. And I deselect and look at this. I'm very happy with this, the stuff that happened on the left-hand side of the image, but I'm not very happy about the top one. I will try to undo and just do it one more time. This time I want to select a little bit more of the image. And I click fill. And we wait. And this looks better color-wise. We have another obvious issue, but we can fix that. I click apply. I wait a second, let the app do its thing, and then we can start to look at our issues here. First one, very obvious. Affinity took a part of the wing to clone in up here. We go back to our photo persona here, and I go to my inpainting brush that we used in the first video. I just use a soft brush and I simply paint it over and wait, and now it's gone. So this part was fairly easy, and I don't see any other issues with the top part of this image. but I do see a few things that I want to fix on the left hand side here. And this is stuff that happens in the same way that what we see when we use the inpainting tool, the inpainting brush. We get these small lines here, and we don't want that. To fix it, we do the same thing as we learned in the first video. Use the clone stamp tool, or clone brush, and we set a fairly large, very soft brush, and only with a flow of about 30. And then I can even out and blend this part here. And another thing we talked about in the first video was shallow depth of field. In this image here, we have a part of the image that's in focus right here, and then everything else is actually out of focus. And we don't want to clone something from this part up here, down here, because then it'll be out of focus in this part here. That's not what we want. Then we undo that. So we choose a source that's in the same plane of focus as what we're trying to fix. And then when we move up, the source moves with us, and we can blend it in a lot more natural looking way here. And as you see here, I wasn't completely aligned here with my source. So I go back, bit smaller brush, and I make sure to line up here with the source between my brush and the source, because then when I go through this, it looks more natural. And do the same up here. And then we want to remove some of those places that are obviously cloned. We talked about it in the first video. We don't want to have anything that looks like repetition. So it's important when doing this that we zoom out every once in a while just to see what it looks like, because then it will be very obvious if something looks cloned. In this case, I'm still not very happy about this place. So I will take something from in here and I will break it up a bit. Like this. And now we can go back here and just adjust the crop as we want to. And now we have an image that has a nicer composition than what we started off with. So this was just a quick run through. The possibilities are endless when it comes to this kind of thing. There are other ways you can do this, but I want to keep that for another time, for another video. So this is what I had for today. I hope you liked it. And if you have any comments or questions, please let me know in the comments below. If you have any requests for a next video or for a subject or anything you want me to explain in the upcoming videos, please let me know in the comments as well. Otherwise, I will see you next time. Take care.